Historically, Latinos have been virtually invisible in the media.
I like to be in America, okay by me in America.
And when they were portrayed, it was usually the same stereotypical roles.
Badges. We ain't got no badges. We don't need no badges. I don't have to show you any stinking badges.
But it's necessary that we have a visibility to explain who we are, what we are, and how much we are worth. Other than that, we're absent.
Today, film, television, radio, and newspapers reflect more diversity than ever before, thanks in no small part to 25 years of consistent pressure and commitment by the National Hispanic Media Coalition.
It was a real struggle, and I think it's important to know and to document in that struggle the selflessness with which everyone acted. We were all unpaid staff at the time. Everybody was a volunteer.
In pursuit of its mission for media equality, the group's strategy in its first 10 years was to file more than 100 petitions with the FCC to deny the renewal of licenses of television and radio stations nationwide. Picketing and boycotting was another key strategy.
The way we got Howard Stern to back away from attacking Selena was by going after his advertisers. As a result of that, he not only stopped attacking Selena, but he actually apologized.
In 1992, the coalition won another important victory. It negotiated with Univision to develop quality children's programming. Plaza Sésamo, Sesame Street in Spanish, made it to air.
They resisted it. For months they resisted it because they didn't want to pay the licensing fees. In the end, what we are asking for is in fact what's good for everyone. It's good for the community, but it's also good for the stations.
As the years progressed and the marketplace changed, the coalition redefined and reconfigured itself to expand its strategies to include the argument that Latino purchasing power, over $1 trillion today, cannot be ignored. So in 1999, when the coalition insisted the networks hire more Latinos and the networks didn't even want to meet with them, the coalition called for a national TV brownout. Shortly thereafter, an LA Times story reported that out of 26 new primetime network shows, there was not one single leading character of color.
They have to be equitable with us. We want what is rightfully ours, a part of the American pie, a part of the media American pie.
That same year, the coalition joined forces with the National Latino Media Council, the NAACP, the Asian Pacific American Media Coalition, and the American Indians in Film and TV, and created the Multi-Ethnic Media Coalition, which signed historic memorandums of understanding with ABC, CBS, NBC, and Fox, all pledging to make their lineups and workforces more diverse.
They had to bend to public pressure, to public scrutiny, to public condemnation, not only by Latinos, but others as well, who were saying the same thing. How can you keep a whole population excluded from programming, from jobs?
The Multi-Ethnic Media Coalition monitors the network's progress through annual report cards. However, progress has been slow and incremental.
This year, the networks failed us. When it came to Latinos, we were down.
Still, the coalition continues to fight for representational parity across all media platforms. In 2004, they took on Nielsen for undercounting Latino viewers, which could have meant the cancellation of Latino-themed shows.
But we won as well. We now have, you know, very outstanding Latinos and Latinas in the hierarchy of Nielsen that are very sensitive to our needs, that in fact are right there to make sure that Latinos are properly counted.
That same year, in response to the continued lack of diverse writers in primetime network TV, the coalition created its television writing program in hopes that if there were more people of color at the writers' table, more diversity would be reflected on the small screen.
We have now placed over 15 of those writers from this program. They're successful, they're out there, they're working.
Meanwhile, the coalition is battling another important issue, minority media ownership. A recent study shows Latinos own less than 3% of radio stations and just over 1% of TV stations nationwide. So the group held hearings with FCC commissioners and testified before Congress, arguing that the more media giants consolidate, the more diversity vanishes, and the prospect of minority media ownership disappears along with it.
We have to have our own properties, where in fact we can hire, we can fire, we can put content on that is directed very specifically at our community.
And that may happen if the memorandum of understanding recently signed between the coalition and Comcast and other Hispanic groups is adhered to. Comcast, which has acquired NBC Universal, is pledging to create 4 new Latino networks, and that may open up doors for Latino ownership.
That is exactly what this is going to provide, a window to who the Latino community is and how creative we can be when given the opportunity.
At a time when hate crimes against Latinos are at an all-time high, the coalition in 2007 launched an aggressive campaign against hateful speech on the airwaves.
What jobs do the women and the children do that we have to have them here, other than the children's job is to dumb down the American children and overpopulate our schools?
It filed a petition for inquiry with the FCC to ask for an investigation into the connection between hate speech and hate crimes. But over 2 years later, nothing has been done.
If you say a lie long enough, at a certain point, people are going to believe it and act on that. If we don't raise our voices, if we don't raise our concerns, it'll keep on going.
So the coalition partnered up with UCLA's Chicano Studies Research Center, which is currently conducting 3 reports examining hate crimes and hate speech. 2 of those studies are done, and 1 more will be issued by this coming April. Today, the battle for media equality and fairness rage on, such as it did under the leadership of the first chair, Armando Duron, the second chair, Esther Renteria, and Alex Nogales for the last 15 years. All agree there is further work still to do, but there is much to be proud of.
The strides that we have made to uplift our community, you can't put a price on.
We weren't doing it for ourselves, we were doing it for the future.
We were making a big difference in the lives not only of our peers, but also in terms of what was to be there for our children. Opportunity.